Marshall Ward. Quit. I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road.
Hi.
Oh, I didn't know we were on.
We're on. Hi. I'm Max.
I'm Debbie. And this is Max and Debbie Go Thrifting.
I thought it was Debbie and Max Go Thrifting. They get confused when we start doing that.
Well, I'm confused, so it's only appropriate
everybody else is too. Well, it's been one of those wonderful days where people get confused.
It's Wednesday, the
9th. 9th? It says 10 right there.
Oh, I wrote a thing today, and they had the little date thing there, and it said 9th.
Mm-hmm. They were wrong. Today's the 10th.
Like, they still get the money.
Yeah, that's true. They'll just get it a day ahead of time, won't they?
So, you are not getting the bad weather that's around. Oh, I guess we should tell. If you've never been before, never watched us before, we do a little bit of thrifting and hauling and auctioning and whatever fancies us.
Yeah. Good enough.
Yeah. My two things I love are books and vintage jewelry, but I do sell other things to make my habit for the other things affordable. I got a huge lot of jewelry at an auction on September the 27th, and this is the third
video
segment of that. I paid $222.99, and we're going piece by piece and showing you what we got. I had no idea what it was getting, I got it. Most of the pieces were 25-50 cents a dollar. The only thing I paid more for. No. I didn't pay more than that for anything. So, these three, I went out today, pouring down rain like an idiot.
Yeah.
And I picked these up at the Salvation Army. Our Goodwills are closing here.
We've lost three of them now.
Four. We had like eight Goodwill that were fabulous, yeah, and there were really good ones. And
yeah, I think four have closed now.
Well run, clean. The employees were wonderful, and all of a sudden, wham! They came in and cut them in half, and I'm at the point almost of just not even going anymore. The prices are ridiculous. But the jewelry, which I really like, all they're bringing in is that Chinese jewelry and selling it new for $3.99 a piece.
Except plastic stuff and.
Well, yeah, and the vintage stuff. I guess they're sending it to the online.
All goes to the online stuff, and they.
It's just ridiculous the prices. I mean, they didn't just like go up a little; they went up like 75%, 100% on things. It's just ridiculous. And a lot of it's broken, you know? I mean, I could see a broken something that you might could fix, a watch or, something, but a broken, like, kid's toy with the wheels off or something. Okay. Oh, I'm getting off. We're trying to stay on for 1 hour only because I rattle. But anyway, these are the three pieces. I rattle and ramble.
Oh, well, okay.
I got these for 99 cents a piece at the Salvation Army. When I was so depressed at going to Goodwill, I went over to the Salvation Army. And I saw, it's funny, there was a couple. Well, the guy is actually managing the Salvation Army store now. And his wife was in there visiting them. And we used to play poker with them probably 5 or 6 years ago.
Yeah.
And they moved to Virginia Beach, and they are now back in Roanoke, and so I got to see them. And
the Ark.
It's has a name on the back.
Well, I didn't see anything on there.
Yeah, it does. All three of them do.
Could you? Oh, there. Oh, boy. I was looking and looking, trying to find it, and I couldn't find it. And then I just saw it. All right. Avon?
Yep.
Yep, looks like Avon. There you go. And then the next one also has a name on it. Something limited.
14-karat.
Oh, 14-karat
gold in something. Limited SP. Okay, if you know, somebody told me in the last one, a red necklace that I had put up, and I didn't know what it was.
Yeah, yeah.
And they very helpfully told me what it was.
Yeah, that's interesting.
And for some strange reason, I keep getting Premier Designs and Princess confused. I don't know why. But if you know what this one is, what was it we thought it said? Something limited?
14-karat gold. I think it said limited.
It's electroplated. That's what the
E is. Oh, that's what that is. Electroplated. That's a pretty little piece.
Yeah, I know it says something on it. And it says something limited, right?
Yeah, it's 14 karat gold, E, means electroplated, and then it looks limited, and then that other character that was underneath that.
Yeah, if you know what this is, help us out. We're two elderly folk who could use help.
That one.
That's a cute little piece.
Yeah. That's about that. Let's take a look at the... First, I got to find it.
And that is vintage. And why is that vintage?
Because it's got the V.
I'm trying to teach him. Show them.
Got the...
It's big, huge Hulk hands.
Big V. You said it's marked, huh?
Mm-hmm. Probably all three were. Maybe I just picked it up because of the vintage. Let me look again.
Take a look. I'm not finding anything on that one. But, you know. It's...
It may have been the vintage.
Just to the vintage, the way the clasp. What if they start making clasps like that?
I wouldn't put it past China.
Yeah.
I have nothing against China as long as they mark their stuff and don't do copies of things. You know, if you want a $200 purse, but you want it for $20,
so see it a lot better.
That's fine, but they need to put something on there that says this is.
Yeah. But that's the backside.
A $20 purse, not the $200 fakey.
Let's grab something out of here. Now, on to the.
We have no idea what's in here. Yeah.
Designs by Sue Nagel. Yeah.
Hand painted wood, I
say. Hand painted wood, yep.
Patriotic.
Paint in time. Well, that has to be a mark. Let me get under the microscope here and see what this is. Sarah Coventry, I bet. That's what the other word is. Ever since the first one is Sarah.
Yeah, and Sarah Coventry... through the years, and she was around for a long time.
Yeah,
she
could just barely make it up. Yeah, but that's Sarah Comforter.
There were a number of Marx movies because it was bought by a company. I actually have the information, but yeah,
that's what it looks like.
The companies were bought. It changed trademarks or names. Some say Sarah, some say Sarah Cub. I think the early ones might say Cub and Tree. I'm not sure, but there's several marks out there.
There.
My mom had this brooch. I remember it well. Oh, I remember it well.
Yeah. Turn that back on. You can see the
critter.
A fly of butter.
A critter.
And on the back, you can see that very distinctive V shape.
Vintage. I like that.
Yeah.
Which is a little more colorful. I'm a little loud.
Okay.
You should have seen me.
You can see this.
Bridge yesterday.
Let me get this on though. Cat in a bag, I assume.
What's he getting his mouth?
A little of those things that you, like a party thing.
Oh, he's having a party?
He's having a party.
Party in a bag. Well, if you give a cat a bag, he will have a party.
Yeah.
That looks like copper, huh?
It looks like copper. Feels like copper.
Another handmade piece. That's cute. Oh, I know Saudi. Princess Casserole's husband would love this piece. If he doesn't already have it. He would love this.
Next one. That thing with the big old sparklers on it.
Everything you see is for sale. If you're interested in any piece, contact me either in the replies below or our email is Debbie and Max, M-A-X-X, and the and is A-N-D.
Yep.
GoThrifting@gmail.com. I also have a Facebook page, and I also have a personal Facebook page.
Okay. This is a Debbie necklace.
That's not bright enough.
Yeah, that's true. It's not bright. It's big, though.
Which is
it's got some damage
Debbie Parker,
to it.
And I'm in Roanoke, Virginia.
Yeah, it got some damage to it.
Let's
see that. Let me get it under there. You can see all the colors real well. There, look at that.
What's the damage?
It's scratched right across here and right across there. There's scratches.
Somebody could restring that.
Yeah. And get rid of those two discs.
Yeah, it puts that more interesting in there. I would.
Yeah. It is kind of lackluster.
Been around me too long.
Chain. Oh, I knocked the camera down.
We're so graceful.
Yeah.
Did a lot of belts like that in the 70s. But they let it hang down and swing. Yeah. Of course, none of them would go around me, even back then. I think I got it bought too. I never thought about that. But I didn't exactly want to draw attention to my waistline back then. Oh, it's hammered.
Can't quite read it. But there's markings on here. Oh, Dos Equis. It's a Dos Equis necklace.
What is Dos Equis?
It's a Mexican beer.
Oh.
It's a Dos Equis.
That's unusual. I mean, I wonder if they... How they get the beads?
The beads?
Oh. I mean, did they do transfers or did they paint it? Or
They look like it's etched into the bead. Let me get it under the scope so I can get a real good look at it. One of these. Yeah, definitely says Dos Equis. And up above it, it says that. which is
Cerveza.
Cerveza, yeah, thank you. And you can tell there's a texture to it. It's the bead was painted and this was scratched into it. Another colorful necklace. And where's the
what?
There it is. It looks like it would work on here very well. Yeah. That really shows off the color. Look at that. I can hold it straight. Yeah, that's
good. Is it stone or plastic?
It's cold, so I think it's stone.
That is pretty. Those are,
These
are halites, probably.
Yeah.
Dyed to look
dyed,
like,
that's it. That's the word.
Turquoise, but they're not. It's still pretty.
It's not turquoise.
The color is very pretty.
Look at this untangled.
Nice necklace. We are working on the auction we want to have. I'm going to try my best to have put it up Sunday. We've thought about it and changed this and changed that and.
That's nice.
But, it's not going to be alive.
I didn't see a tag on it anywhere, but
we want to give more people a chance because we don't have very many
subscribers. Oh, it's going to be live now?
No, I said it's not.
Not going to be live. Oh, okay.
We don't have a lot of subscribers, so we want to give our subscribers, we do have time to...
look at everything. Huh?
Look at everything, so we're going to run it. Kind of like if you watch Tanya's where she did it and then you gave you several days to place a bid. We're going to kind of do it like that. Like I say, I hope to have it up Saturday.
Okay, I have this big thing here. Turn this on.
That almost looks like the thing we just bought by the wall.
I know, a miniature version of it. You can see that. And then, of course, on the flip side, you can see
vintage.
Vintage.
It was really pretty.
Leaf.
This would be gorgeous on black.
That's one big leaf.
What color was that? What?
That one?
No, that. That's it.
This,
I'm not picking up the color on it. It's copper.
It's silver.
Oh, I just said the back looks copper, doesn't it?
No, silver. On here it might, on this. Oh, yeah, I see. It's picking up light color from somewhere. It's reflecting in somewhere, but that's silver.
Yeah, I just put a leaf lot on eBay because they're supposed to be hot right now because of fall and stuff. Yeah, of course.
This next one is marked. If we can pick that up in there.
Anyway, I don't know if I finished saying I hope everybody's safe. Genies?
Genies.
Oh, I never heard of that.
Yeah. Well, it's a little art piece.
We're getting a ton of rain, but...
put it under the other camera here so you can see it really well.
That's not that big a deal.
It's just kind of like a random pattern. You want to check that for silver?
Well, you've got the kit over there.
I do?
In the bag, magnets are in side pockets.
One of these pockets?
Yeah.
Oh, what's that? Open. They're going away. They're running away, further away, I think, if that's the magnet I got. No, that's a tape measure.
I don't think it is. It's very light.
Yeah, it does feel kind of light, but I have no idea where the magnets are.
They're in one of the side pockets?
Yeah, well, there's 20 side pockets.
Oh, no, that's why I got it. Everything to do with jewelry is in there.
Is it in this pocket? Is there other things besides magnets in the pocket?
Well, everything that has to do with jewelry.
Ah, that's definitely, I can tell by the way too way down there. Ah, now my hand's stuck in the bag. No? Not sticking. Not even the pin, the thing. Nothing.
Huh.
Well, I said it kind of had that feel of pile. Had that feel of silver to it, so.
Two pieces of sterling we found. Not fabulously big, but.
Okay, I see that. There's a all sorts of. Can't really. It's all wires. It's all wiry.
Wow.
It's wiry. No markings on it though.
Y'all could tell us too. Can you see the drawer? We.
We're trying.
We've tried a bunch of different things, and my hands are so shaky, and Max's hands are huge.
That's what I'm trying
so
to get.
Holding it. Was just not doing
holding
it.
Up like this, my hand
yeah.
is just so much bigger than the
it,
piece.
It was not giving
so
it.
So I'm trying to put it down here on this and turn on this
it's
other camera.
It's not showing the beauty of it.
And
so.
This is small, but. And, but it's a little tiny leaf. It's a pendant type leaf. It's got the little loop
or
on there.
Or a charm.
Or a charm. Yeah, it could be a charm.
Did you see if there's anything on the back?
I was looking at it. I couldn't see anything markings on it, so.
It's the magnet. You didn't put it back, did you?
Oh, that's right. I have it. It's still in my hand.
I have it right here. I just put it
right
okay.
there. Okay. In case. Well, that's... You can hear that one stuck. Goes click! Magnet likes that one. Ooh, a stretchy bracelet.
Silver. Hmm.
I was not expecting that not to stick.
They don't make stretchy bracelets in that.
This has to be, like, plastic, then. It must be plastic.
Yeah, I can do that.
Yeah, wow. It's a stretchy bracelet. Yeah, it's so light it has to be plastic.
I'm not sure, it's feel metal. I'll remember this.
And I've got a charm bracelet here.
Oh, really?
It's all hearts.
Oh, God.
And there's a... Little, oh, and it's marked.
Why I don't like hearts. They're just... I don't know. You know, there's just like some things you don't like, and hearts happen to be mine. That looks like sterling. Let's get that in there. I cannot read that. 12? Carrot?
Is that a 925 off to the right top row?
It might be, but I'm trying to read what's under it.
Yeah, it keeps shifting here. There we go.
I know some of y'all just go, oh, and you're going to read it with your eyes. Oh, Lord, people. You'll never know when you get old.
Oh, NAU, whatever. What's that one? We see them. I think.
You know, I know y'all screaming at us. I know you are. But
it's this! Can't you read it?
No. And I know, because I've watched, and for some strange reason, y'all can see it a lot better than we can. Sitting here, because like,
well,
if you
we
show
don't have,
something...
We don't have the full screen.
Well, if you show something, I can go, oh, that's so-and-so, and you go, I can't read it. And I'm like, why not? It's huge. I cannot read that. But it looks like it's a something
it
carrot.
Like well, that... Maybe I got it upside down.
Well, try the magnet. No, because the 12 carat was right.
That's my thumbnail.
He keeps his hands very clean for a man. I guess it's very salting then, but. When I was dating, that's one thing I always noticed.
No, I just can't make it out.
Okay. Well, it didn't attach to the magnet.
No, not
it's
at all.
It's not.
So.
Again, it's light.
Very light, but this, it's just.
And those of you who do sell
usually
your.
Usually don't have those tags on unless there's something about them.
Gold so. And silver.
And a bracelet.
How do you go about finding somebody you trust to sell your gold and silver to? You know? I mean, you could get, if you don't know enough about it, you could get ripped off. I'm trying to think of a polite word.
Recognize that?
No.
TW? I got it upside down.
No. TW.
Or WT?
No, it wouldn't be.
Well, it's not a M.
Okay, we need more help. It's so sad. What is it?
There. It looks like. Look at this. Well, this is a stretchy bracelet. I don't have to worry about this one. But it's a colorful, stretchy bracelet. And it's plastic, not stone. Another bag. Or two. That's big.
Don't forget to keep watching this time.
Yeah, it's 26 minutes. Going.
And for our viewers who turn in for our non-jewelry things, we're sorry. I just got this lot. And
yeah, and it's taken us some time to go through it because there's so much here. Okay, let's see what this marking is. I'm starting to see a lot more marked stuff. Oops, something went down.
Yeah. The magnet is being grabby.
You make that up?
MTJIWJM.
Oh, I got it upside down. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna... Yeah, MJ.
Mary Jones?
Could be. It's a big thing.
Michael Jackson?
Ooh, we're rich. One of his. Look at this thing. Found it.
I think. I found one. I don't know how many fell.
Yeah, as far as I know, there's only one.
Okay, what was the... That one's the MJ?
Yeah, this is the MJ.
I can probably Google them and find them. I just didn't want to... I like when I open them and y'all get to see them.
I already gave you that one.
Y'all get to see me open them too. It's a surprise! Surprise!
And we got a pin. Jesus is the reason for the season. There. Okay, this one here. Oh, this has got a mark in. Oh boy, I have a lot of mark stuff here.
Good.
LC, Liz Claiborne. I'm starting to learn this stuff.
Oh, I'm so proud. Yeah. I'm so proud of you.
It's a pineapple. Look at that thing. It's shiny, too.
I love Liz Claiborne. I love her clothes. I had to dress for work.
Another marked one.
I bought a lot of her stuff. Of course, I worked in a store that sold it and got it by discount. And also the girl that worked in the plus size department knew I loved it and she'd be sneaky and...
A-A...
I.
I?
Mm-hmm.
That's what it is?
Yeah.
Okay. You know what that is? I don't.
That one I know. I recognize. Okay. That's what is it? Well, put it.
Yeah, I'm about to put it up there.
It's an angel?
Yeah, an angel. Here's a owl. It won't show up down there because it's white and white on white. Just
well, here.
See him. See him.
Put him on there. We got this too. You can show. I mean, we got what's in it, but put him on there and they can see it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I don't know why we got. They had this one piece in the.
Yeah, you know, like I said, the white is
going
to wash out.
He's cute. He's,
Let me get a little shade on
him. What is he? Not Mother Pearl, is he?
No. It looks, feels like plastic, but...
Yeah, could be.
And I do believe that is a marking, yes. We haven't showed that yet, but we're going to show it here eventually. Huh?
I'll just get another way.
Okay.
Switch.
The number, and then there's those letters right up above it.
Huh.
SFJ, and then it's got 48684.
Oh, wait a minute. Let me write that down.
Yeah, definitely. S. There, you got a real clear view of it right there.
SFJ.
Yeah.
What's the number?
48684.
San Francisco jewelry, maybe? I don't know.
Yeah.
Things I know very... I love it, and I collect it, and I've got tons of it, but I know very... Oh.
Yeah, right there. Oh, I haven't even shown the front part.
Oh.
I'm trying to make out what it is.
It's Easter.
Oh, Easter baskets with eggs. Yeah. That's neat.
It may not find its way to
it. It may not find its way into anywhere.
Let's put this one over here.
This is painted copper by the looks of it. Christmas tree. With one single ornament on it. Mm. And a
minimalist.
Minimalist. And we got a pair of hedgehog earrings or pins. These are pins, these aren't earrings. Boy, yeah. That'd hurt to put these on, I tell you.
Yeah, they're losing their
yeah.
Color. Go, I don't know what you put it. They're not enamel. They're kind of the plating is wearing, not plating, but they're just wearing off, whatever you call it. Has anybody tried the new gold flake pen thing? I heard it being talked about, and a bunch of people were going to try it, and Bougie and Angie, and I think Tanya was going to try it, and I haven't seen anybody who said they tried it yet, but yeah, let me know if you tried it, or even if you're doing a video, show us what happened, or what if it worked or not work. Yeah.
Be.
Or not to be.
Yep. Nope. This is next. Yeah. Okay. We saw the box. And in the box, it says.
It's a really ugly box.
Yeah. But it's got a
stone necklace.
Stone, very. Boy, this is heavy stone, too.
We have rock and gem mineral shows here all the time. I should take some of this up.
Yeah.
And see if they would tell me like what some of this stuff is.
Look at that. I mean, this, that's Lots of neat looking stones in there. Oh, look at that one.
I may do that when I'm going through sorting. I may pile up a bunch. I didn't think these, the bees were plain. Did you hear that?
Yeah. Yeah, those are kind of like a cord. It's not actually a bead, but it's a cord that's all tied up with wire. Yeah,
yeah, that's really
kind of neat, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Next bag! There's something bright and long.
It sounds like it's metal.
It's a... Buttons. Well, some of them are... You know, that could be... that actually could be coconut right there.
Mm. Yeah, it's something you'd say like at a resort or something.
See, this piece here, these here, look, they have the feel and look of coconut.
That's long.
Look at that. You can see the check there. Get one there that like that one there. You can see the pattern.
I
mean,
it is hot pink.
Yeah.
It's kind of the camera's kind of a little off, but it is hot pink.
Yeah.
I don't like that, but
whether that's really coconut or not, I don't know. But it kind of looks like it.
Well, they use it a lot for Aloha shirts and stuff, and it'd be great for like a tropical little. A souvenir shop or something.
This monster. Big old hunk of metal. It was, looks like it was electroplated at one time. And it is wearing off. And then they, well, I don't know, this, or is that solder that's on there? It could be solder that's on the surface. And this is copper, or yeah, I think it's copper. You look on the other side, it's got that look of copper to it. But yeah, anyway, that's that one. This one's colorful. That big thing.
That's like the
Aztec type kind of.
Yeah, I was thinking pattern. Southwest.
Southwest. Colors. Aztec, yeah.
And it's wood.
And it's wood, yeah. That one's wood. And this is also wood.
I don't know. I go back and forth. I do like some painted pieces, but I also like the some of the natural woods too.
See this? That's all wood.
No, it's so good this time of year with the golds and the greens and the all them pretty colors.
What's that? Oh, this is marked. I almost read it, in fact. So,
Chico's.
Is that something you know?
Yeah.
Okay. Chico's.
Hate the rawhide. Definitely. I'm not. Well, it itches my neck. Hmm. I have a. Well, I get them. I order chains, gold and silver, gold plated. Gold something. So if I want to change. Something out, I can do it. And then I order sterling silver chains to keep on hand too. If I want to change a piece or I find a pin doesn't have one.
Thought I caught a glimpse of a mark when I was pulling this out of the bag. Okay.
It's upside down, but
turn right side up, and this looks a little...
PD. With a crown.
With a crown over it. And then a wreath.
PD, crown, and a wreath.
Yeah. Interesting.
I just said that earlier. I forgot.
There it is.
What is it?
It's a bracelet. With a lot of sparklies on it. It's a little leather and... Yeah. And we got a stretchy bracelet. With hearts. All hearts. Look at that.
Metal?
Oh yeah, that's definitely metal. It got some weight to it. There. Looking for markings. Don't see any.
That's got a safety chain. That's unusual.
Yeah, this is one of these.
One of these. It's a bangle.
It's a, well, yeah, whatever you call it. And you open it up and there's that little chain.
Safety chain.
Yep.
What'd you do with the magnet?
I don't know. You threw it last time I saw. You said it was sticking to the jewelry.
No, I didn't throw it. I was trying. Oh, here it is. Not sticking to the magnet. I thought it was awful strange.
This one has a magnet built in.
The chain...
It sticks to the magnet.
Sticks. But the bracelet...
Does this one.
So anyway, yeah, we're kind of...
It opens. There's a magnet right there.
Getting a stash of...
kind of faux bamboo.
Silver. So I'm interested to hear how you choose... I have a jeweler I use for my...
Your personal jewelry.
Personal jewelry, having things made and stuff. But they don't deal in...
They don't like to deal in the scrap.
They don't deal in... No, they don't deal in sterling.
Yeah, she'll gold. She'll take gold. That's right. I forgot.
But they will not take sterling. Okay. So I would have to go to like a pawn shop or something. And I don't know, you know...
How do you determine whether it's a good pawn shop or a bad pawn shop? And one that's going, yeah, this is just, this is Bulgarian silver hammered in. I'll give you a dollar for it. We wouldn't know. We don't know. Oh, look at that.
Luckily, we have no attachment to any of this.
A ghost.
So,
it's a pin.
Honey, it's a snowman.
Okay, it's a snowman. It's white and okay. Yeah, all right. It's a snowman. I forgot about the carrot and the hat.
And the holly.
How do you know it's not a dead snowman? And it's come back to haunt us. More bracelets. Let's take one of these big ones here. Can't miss these. Great big
plastic.
Bracelets. Plastic. Hear that?
Daisy, stop it.
She's pawing at the bed again.
She likes to make her bed on
our
bed.
Our bed. She likes to rearrange it to her own specifications, which do not really meet up with our specifications. That's interesting.
Yeah, but it's no use for us to make our bed because Daisy Ann makes it. That's pretty.
Bracelet. There's a hunk of metal. Oh, it opens. Boy, that had got some teeth there. Look at this thing. Yep. And I'm going to leave it on. This is stone. Oh, this is stone. I always thought, I thought it was plastic. But that's stone. And it's got little things in there. And...
That one red one looks like it's
that one there.
Close in A.
Yeah, you're right.
It's close in A. That's strange to have one close in A bead.
Why would it have one bead? And only one bead on the whole thing that looks like that. That's interesting. Look at that, you see the little metal in there. Take a look at it.
I mean, I know it's closing on it. I've had closing on it over the years. Enjoyed it. I liked it.
More bracelets.
What time is it?
We're at 45 minutes.
Okay.
This is plastic.
Mm-hmm. Bangle.
Wood with metal inset. It looks, I don't know if it looks like, yeah, there's a chunk missing out of it right there. But aside from that, you,
would have been a nice bracelet.
Yeah, you can see where something was glued in there. And this is, and it slips and it slides. You play it like a hula hoop. And swing it around.
I could probably do my wrist. I can't do my waist.
And another wood one?
That wood, that's plastic.
No, this is wood. Yeah, that's wood. That's definitely wood. Feel the grain in it. This is really well molded plastic, but no. This is also wood. And I reach and grab another bag out of the bag. This never-ending bag of jewelry. Uh-oh. Something's not happy.
The bucket's overflowing that I'm putting stuff in on the floor.
Got a set of earrings.
Those are pretty.
These here. Washing them out. Like shields.
I was thinking coins.
Or coins, yeah. They got that concave shape to them.
Those are really pretty.
And here's another set of earrings, except they got that caught in them. There, that would not be right. And those. There's loops and hang there. Earrings. And let me untangle these. And we got another. Oops, hit the button. There. Another set of earrings.
So, would you have taken a chance for $222 for this amount of jewelry? I honestly, I did not know
how much was
how much was there. I knew it was a lot.
And more earrings. And then a set of studs. I would assume they are fakes, but if they're not, that's some big rock. Oh, I keep hitting the button. I don't know where like that. I don't know if I can get any closer to that. But you can see that little sparkler in there. His little studs.
He wishes.
Yeah, I wish, but
I'm driving him nuts. I want a pair of.
We do have a diamond tester. We could test it real quick, but I'm pretty sure it would not. Come on, be diamond, not something that big. Nobody gives up diamonds that big.
Well, unless they're cleaning out an estate and they don't know.
They don't notice it?
They don't know.
Well, take a look at it. See what you think.
I mean, no, we wouldn't mind it if it was.
Yeah.
You have the worst luck. We really do. It's sad. We could enter a raffle and be the only people who entered, and we still wouldn't win.
Mm-hmm. at first I thought they were metal, but I think they're plastic. There's a pair of little earrings. Yeah, you hear that? They're plastic. Really, really cheap earrings. Okay, this says Caliente?
That's what it says.
Maybe you can see that. Oh yeah, shows up quite well. There are little hoops there with the red stones. They're pins.
They're
pierced. Pierced, yeah, pins. I know what that is.
And you know, it's just enough to make them dangerous.
Yep. When it comes to this stuff, yeah.
Premier Designs Incorporated. Oh, that's what that was. Look.
Oh, Premier PD. Now I know what that is.
Yeah.
It's got that same symbol. Premier Designs. Solid wood earrings. Cheney and Company. Ages 13 plus. Choking hazard. I think that's kind of just interesting. And you see they're kind of like flags. They're carved out of wood. $9.99 was the original price on them.
Somebody gave these to somebody for a trip or something, or birthday or Christmas, and as soon as that person left, the person in the room with them turned to him and went, "Can you believe they bought me that?" Lebanon, Tennessee.
I think that was going to stick. These might be silver. Pair of peace symbol earrings. They're stone, some sort, backing. And they don't stick. And it's double, so you got the big peace symbol, then right up there, there's another tiny peace symbol. Right up.
Those are neat.
That's neat.
I like those.
And they're for pierced ears. And they might be silver. Don't stick at all, do they? And they got that look of silver.
That
piece, the clasp, yeah. But the...
I actually have been wanting a pair of peace symbol earrings.
Yeah. Well, those are very nice looking. I like those. I like the double peace symbol on them, too.
I haven't been able to find any.
Then you want something a little more weight to it. Got these earrings. They're wood and plastic beads, it feels like. Yeah. We're at 53 minutes. You do one more? Well, okay. Well, I expected to get more than that out of the bag. Got a couple of rings.
The sizer's in the bag.
There. Okay, I thought I saw. I had to put that on. There's a number on the inside of this one. Nine and a half.
That's what I wear.
And a nine.
This is plastic. You can't see.
Where is it? Oh, there you go. Is it plastic?
Yeah, it's plastic. But it sure does sparkle.
You sure that's plastic?
Yeah.
Sure looks like metal to me, but and it's got the engraved number on there. I don't know if I can get it on the microscope or not, to the shape of this thing, but I'm going to give it a try. 99.25. You sure that's plastic?
Well, here, put it on the magnet.
Well, plastic won't stick, and metal. I It might be. I don't know. I don't think it's plastic. This one has a mark too. PD.
Princess Designs.
Premier Designs.
Premier. See, I'm doing the same thing again.
Well, you got Princess on your mind.
I don't know what it is. And I've never been to one of their parties. I understand the jewelry at those parties is really expensive. The size of that one.
This was the... I told you the sizes. No, I don't remember. I think this was a 9. Yeah, comes in right around a 9.
That's kind of neat looking.
Yeah, it is. I'll do this one, and we'll wrap her up for the night. More bracelets! Here's a orange plastic. This one. Oddly shaped. Translucent green. You like green, don't you?
Oh, not this.
Yeah, okay. What about this bamboo one?
Oh, big on the bangles. Unlike Angie, I like the stretchy bracelets. Because I have really big wrists.
This looks like... Not only is it wood, it's press wood. Because it's got that wood feel to it, but there's absolutely no grain at all in it anywhere. So that's probably press wood. This one's, I think, brass or copper.
Boy, I'm getting a lot of copper bracelets.
I think it's copper, too. Just put it on your wrist and a couple hours you start turning green, you'll know you got copper.
They make a lot of jewelry out of copper.
Yeah.
Some people think it's like healthy or does something. I don't know. Boy, this is really light.
Yeah, it's very. It's 2 pieces and it's hollow on the inside.
Okay. Is that show and tell for tonight?
That's show and tell for tonight.
So, we still have more.
Oh, yeah. We got. You better hold that bag. I don't want to rip it. This much more.
I know. Again, would you have paid $222 for all that jewelry? Well, the next one will be the 4th thing.
It'll be the 4th show. I don't think we'll get it through. Maybe. I don't know. It's probably going to be 2 more shows to get through.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah.
And tomorrow we're going to another book sale.
Book sale tomorrow, yep.
And I've got to decide if I
want... That's the one that's tomorrow night, right?
No, it's the box day.
Oh, the box day. Tomorrow's Thursday.
Yeah,
Friday,
$3 a box.
Yeah, all these book sales.
Yeah, and I'm investing a lot of money in these, and I need to decide... it's like I'm an addict. I really am. Books. And I know I can make money off of them, it's weight. I mean, you know that.
Yeah.
You buy $200 worth of inventory to sell for $600, and you want the $600, you know, a week later. And unfortunately, it doesn't work that way.
The other day when we volunteered for the library book sale, we were sitting there going, well, you know, we might pick up a few books. 200 books we picked up. I guess that's a few.
They were 50 cents a piece.
Well, yeah, they were.
And
they were.
I know I got
some really,
good books.
Good books. I know. I was helping sort them. I saw.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, those good books. I wasn't complaining. I was just saying 200 books, and that's before the sales start.
All paperback, because the hardbacks were $2 a piece.
Yeah.
And unless it's something I want for myself, I will not pay that. So now tomorrow I'll go back and go through the hardbacks and see if there's anything I want. But the thing about it is, today was half price day, so you had more people coming in. And tomorrow they open the doors at 9 for box day, and you will have dealers and store owners coming in and just wham, you know, they'll take out whole sections. So, but you know, I used to be more avid at it than I am.
That's true.
But I still love it. Put me in a room full of books, and you know, I'm in love. I told Max today, with all this rain, oh, I could have curled up with a book and just spent the day listening to the rain, and you know, just enjoyed my day. But unfortunately, anything else we need to tell him? eBay still being weird. eBay is still accepting best offers for us, even though we don't have a best offer. Luckily, it hasn't been anything huge so far. So it was something that if they had offered, you know, said to us, "Will you take this best offer?" We would have. Yeah. It was a small enough amount. But yeah, they're doing that. What else happened? It's just really weird because we rarely get complaints or returns or anything, and somebody switched two labels up, and they
it was a busy day.
Each got each other's packages,
and we got that straight.
So it's funny, we heard from the one guy, and was he hot?
He was hot.
I mean, he didn't even like
give you a chance.
Excuse me, I think you. You know, mailed the wrong. Don't know. I mean, it was hot. It was like, you low down, na 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 na. And I'm like, whoa. So, one of my friends told me to go outside and throw a rock and walk around for 15 minutes and then come back before I replied. And I did it. And it was, he came back and apologized and said, you know, fine. And we're going to make, you know, of course we always make it right for everybody. I haven't heard from the other lady who got his thing yet, which is weird because
you sent her an email. So.
Well, yeah, and he wanted a book and she was ordering a brooch. So I can't imagine she'd be happy with a book if she wanted a brooch.
Unless she saw the book and went, ooh, I never thought of this book before.
I mean.
And it wasn't like a novel or anything. It was one of them instructional books or something.
Yeah. And
lots of philosophical books or something, I forget.
Oh, and then this one, you know, you just get those people sometimes who you just feel like you need to drive to their house and just literally sit down at their computer and order it for them. I'd like to order this. How do I do it?
Yeah.
And you tell them by step.
They came in and they says, well, would you take so much off of the shipping? And it says, well, no, we can't take it off the shipping because it's automatically calculated. But here's what we'll do. We'll get the price down. And I went through and I worked it all out and I got about $3 off of it. So, and I sent it to him. I got it all set up. All I have to do is make an offer for this amount and it's yours. And it comes back, could you send me an invoice?
I don't know how to do this. Could you do something? It took us like 4 days back and forth, but...
He bought it.
It went out today.
Went out today, so I'm not complaining.
No, I mean, you just have to be patient with them. Yeah. You know, they don't shop on eBay every day like we do. And what was the other one? There was something else. Oh, yeah. The guy writes, I really don't need another shirt, but if you'll sell me this one for $5, I'll buy it.
Well, we don't really need to sell another shirt.
Yeah, it's like, well, I'm sorry, but I need more than $5, so you can't have the shirt. It's been that kind of week. Max's work has been strange, too. Yeah. So, yeah. Hopefully, it will start better on Saturday or something. Right? Yeah. I think the rain's going to stop here.
Yeah, it's supposed to end tomorrow.
At Chick-fil-A.
Friday night. Thursday night. The rain's supposed to end.
When God wants it to end, it will end.
That's true.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Because I love Chick-fil-A. sorry if you don't have one where you are. And a lot of people are political and don't even get me started on that. I wouldn't eat there for nothing. They're, you know, it's good food. I'll eat it.
Yep. Eat them all the time. Until they open up a Cane's here. We're eating at Chick-fil-A.
Raising Cane's. If y'all down in Louisiana there.
Now that's good chicken.
Anyway, we're talking. Okay, so we're going to go. It's late.
It's 8:54.
Yep, it's late. We're going to go watch some TV.
Yep.
And Max will work on getting this posted. It is Wednesday night. And
we'll get this up sometime tonight.
If you are any type of higher power, or I don't care, you know, Christian, higher power, anything of that, I have two friends who are really, really going through some stuff right now. One had a double mastectomy today, just a hoot, the sweetest, funniest lady. She didn't even tell us until the day she went in the hospital. She was going to have it done. But she's just, I mean, love her to death. So keep her in your thoughts. And the other one is another friend who was up in Massachusetts on a job. And she literally, and people, I know, and she says she knew it was a stupid thing to do, but she was about to go through a toll, and she has an easy pass. She lives here, but she flies all over the country for work, and she has an easy pass, and she was on a rental car, so it wasn't, like, stuck where it is in her car, and it had slid all the way over to the passenger side windshield, and she thought she should have it over closer, because it wouldn't read where it was at.
But it would. But
yeah, well, and she tried to reach it, and she couldn't. And she unbuckled her seatbelt and grabbed it, and at the same time...
Lost control
of her car, went into the median, and flipped it head over tail three times.
Yeah.
And she's in rough shape. She's... You know they don't keep you in the hospital anymore for them, but what did she... I told you, what did she break?
She broke her C, which is a neck bone.
Yeah.
10, and, 11, 9?
No, and 5 ribs.
Oh, yeah, and 5 ribs.
Yeah. And she's... Oh, you're talking about the number. It was 11.
It was 11, okay.
The C-11. So she's...
Like, very bad thing to break.
Yeah, she's in a brace, and she lives alone, single, and... she is a very important person in the company, and the doctor says he doesn't want her to drive or do anything for like 4 to 6 weeks. And
it's going to be.
And she's already breaking all the rules.
Yeah.
And, you know, I understand, you know, you don't have anybody to go and do for you what you're going to do. But, please keep them in your thoughts and prayers and whatever else, healing, positive energy, because they're both great people, and I like them a lot, and I can't say that about too many people. They've proved me wrong over the years.
You like me. Most days.
Yeah. Okay, so don't get so busy making a living
that you forget to make a life.
Be kind to one another, and kiss everybody you meet. It'll surprise them.
Give them a big kiss.
Yeah.
Just
say
walk
it's,
up.
Say it's from Debbie and Max.
Yeah. Make bye. It a wet one.
Say bye.
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 That God bless the broken road that led me straight to you.